Welcome to Beacon Weekly. Taylor here, joined by Ron, our policy and football expert, to talk about what the NFL draft and legislative session have in common.
Nashville.
And the fact that they both wrapped up last couple of weeks. And so Ron wrote a really great blog post kind of giving us a recap of the legislative session in terms of the NFL draft. And so we're going to go through a list of what was drafted and what was not drafted this year.
Sounds great.
So we're going to start at the top. Your number one draft pick was ESAs.
Yes, absolutely. Woo! You can't go wrong. ESA school choice is something that Beacon has been working on for, I think, almost a decade now. And so the opportunity to finally offer access to an education that best suits the needs of children here in Davidson County and Shelby out in Memphis. You can't top that. Obviously, we would have liked to see it a little broader, but it's something to build off of in years to come, and something that we're very excited about. Consensus number one pick.
Yes, we'll take it. Okay, and also going in the first round this year was hair braiding.
That's right.
The Hair Braiding Freedom Act.
That's right. After going undrafted last year, we're able to bring it back and finally able to get that passed, giving women the chance to just earn a living without having to go through, or guys too, I should say, without having to go through thousands of dollars of tuition and 300 hours of education to learn how to braid hair.
Yes.
I think I remember my sister doing that when she was like five.
Right, so. I know I did. I mean, that's a no-brainer to me, and I'm so excited we got that into the end zone.
And it was
so
really
cool
to see how the women who were so excited, and now it's going to directly impact their lives.
It's really rewarding to see that.
That's right.
Okay, so moving into the mid-round draft pick, we've got tax reform.
Yes.
Which is really awesome for everybody. Everyone should get excited about
this. Absolutely. Everyone should always get excited about tax reform. I think it's really telling where this legislature is going when Governor Lee's first bill he signed into law was a tax cut.
Yeah.
Repealing the gym tax, basically putting all gyms on a level playing field. Otherwise, previously you had the government picking big business over small business, literally by how many square feet its business was, which makes no sense. And then at the end of session, we had reform for the professional privilege tax.
Which is huge.
Exactly. This is something that we've talked about for years, and you know, this idea that it is a privilege to have a job in the state of Tennessee is ridiculous. We were able to repeal it for 15 of the 22 professions. So hopefully next year it could go all the way.
It could go all the way. Okay, speaking of going all the way, our last round or late round draft pick this year is
corporate welfare reform. That's right, with the FACTS Act, which is corporate welfare is something that Beacon has been talking about.
Yeah, you've probably heard us talk about that, speaking of NFL. And
and not picking winners and losers and giving big businesses millions of dollars of money. We saw a small reform in that this year, mandating that every grant that the state gives out has to have accountability agreements and clawbacks.
Get some transparency in here.
Exactly. We've seen that with Electrolux earlier this year, how taxpayers lost $95 million. Yeah. We've made sure that that won't continue going forward. All these deals have to have accountability agreements.
We like that. Accountability agreements.
We still got a lot to do on the transparency side, but did some great work on accountability.
Baby steps. So one thing this year that went undrafted is bail reform. But tell us why. Like, let's talk about what's coming next year.
Well, there's been a lot of talk about needing to go beyond just bail reform to look at all pretrial reform. And so we've even seen leadership and even the governor's administration interested in taking a much broader approach. Mm-hmm. So we're excited to kind of, you know, let's take this, stop this for now and look bigger picture and hopefully come back with something bigger and bolder next year.
We're really
excited with that. Exactly.
Yeah. So something to look forward to, a few things to celebrate and something to look forward to. If you have any questions about what else we had going on this year or what we're looking at for next year, let us know. Thanks for watching and we'll see you next week.
Go Pack Go.